As Apple's a series of mobile processors get more powerful, keeping iPhones cool under heavy demand is becoming difficult. In 2023, we heard all kinds of horror stories of the iPhone 15 Pro overheating. And while there have been less troubling complaints with the iPhone 16, it makes likely Apple would be considering about measures to prevent the problem going forward. A new study claims the business is doing precisely that. According to the Chinese tech blog My Drivers, every model in the iPhone 17 series will utilize vapor chamber technology to keep things chilly even when in intensive use. Currently, iPhones use ordinary heat sinks to draw heat away from processor components. A vapor chamber, as explained here by my colleague Josh Render, a former phone engineer, improves on this with support from fluids contained inside a container. When it's heated, the liquid evaporates and goes to a colder section of the chamber as vapor, distributing the heat around and away from the sensitive components. As it cools, it condenses back into liquid, and the process starts over again. Not only can this move heat further away from delicate components, but it's also quite space efficient, which is useful given the iPhone 17 Air is rumored to be just 5.5 millimeters thick at its thinnest point. To be clear, this is a new technology, and in fact, the best Android phones have incorporated it for some time. Samsung has been periodically employing it since introducing it on the Galaxy S10 Plus in 2019, albeit not regularly. Indeed, an iFixit teardown uncovered two Galaxy Note 20 Ultra devices using two wholly distinct cooling systems. With Apple trying to manufacture the A19 Pro chipset expected to power the iPhone 17 family to the 2-nanometer process, a global first, temperature control could make or break things. Chips running too hot might not only make the phone feel hot to the touch, but can also make software itself unstable, which doesn't make for a great user experience. But there's still a dispute as to whether 2025 is the year when Apple ultimately uses vapor cooling. The corporation was claimed to be aggressively testing a tiny version of vapor chamber cooling as long ago as 2021, but so far nothing has emerged. More recently, the analyst Ming-Chi Kuo said that Apple would introduce the technology this year, but only for the iPhone 17 Pro Max. That would make more sense in a way. Apple's most coveted features launch in the most costly phones after all, for obvious reasons. But if early tests have revealed the new hardware runs hot, then plans may have changed since Kuo made this prediction. We'll find out when the new handsets are introduced to the public in September. Also, do you know Apple patent places Face ID under the screen? A feature we've been waiting years for. We're all familiar with the notch and dynamic island that's graced the display of current iPhones. But Apple is trying to crack the nut of totally under-display Face ID, and a newly published patent reveals us how it might go about doing it. The new patent, Viaphone Arena, is titled Methods and Configurations for Improving the Performance of Sensors Under a Display, and was filed in March 2020 and awarded on January 14, 2025. While the patent outlines various alternative locations where this idea could be used, the core idea is to remove a subpixel from every pixel in the display. Normally there are 4 subpixels per pixel, 1 red, 1 blue, and 2 green. But by eliminating one of them, a space is produced where the infrared light from a Face ID sensor can get through. The eliminated subpixels are distinct for each pixel and are purposefully positioned to make sure there are no major color gaps. Part of the patent also talks about eliminating elements of the display's touchscreen layer, which would eliminate another hurdle between the Face ID sensors and your face. While the cutouts of newer iPhone displays are easier to ignore when you use them enough, they still take up precious area on the screen. Moving the sensors below the panel would mean no need for a notch, but the layers of the display make it hard for sensors to reliably read whatever's on the other side. Which is why this patent recommends a compromise where the display loses some subpixels in order to give the sensors an easier time. Patents don't guarantee a feature will ever make it to a gadget you can actually buy, and if they do, it can take years for a concept claimed by a patent to become reality. So don't expect to see this new display type on the iPhone 17 or iPhone 17 Pro anticipated this fall. Instead, there's a chance we might see this employed in the iPhone 18 series, specifically the iPhone 18 Pro, since Apple rarely delivers new tech to all its iPhones in one generation. There have been rumors of this occurring to the 2026 iPhone previously, so hopefully with this idea given legal protection, Apple will add the innovation once the construction of the iPhone 18 begins. Next, iOS 18.3 beta has came. Here's what's changed. the iOS 18.3 beta has just been released, offering us our first peek at what the forthcoming version will have to offer. It's certainly not as interesting as iOS 18.2, which brings several updates to Apple Intelligence, but there are some key changes that you should be aware of. The upgrade is part of the public and developer versions of the iOS 18.3 beta, meaning anyone signed up to Apple's beta program can apply the update right now. As for when the final version of the update will arrive, that's anyone's guess. Apple is normally pretty cautious about actual release dates, so it'll happen when it happens. Hopefully, it won't take too long. Here's everything that's changed in the iOS 18.3 beta. 1. Changes to notification summaries. Apple has been under a lot of heat for the way its notification summaries functionality treats news. In some circumstances, the AI is straight up making stuff up, which is the last thing we need in an age where disinformation is more common than ever. With that in mind, modifications are being made as of iOS 18.3. The first change is that news summaries have been disabled for all apps in the news and entertainment category, and will remain switched off until Apple has corrected the problem at a later date. The notification summaries area of the settings app will also make it clear that this is an experimental function, and mistakes may arise. Similarly, the setup procedure will encourage users to double-check important information, since summarization may change the meaning of the original headlines. So Apple is putting the onus on the user to fact-check, rather than its AI for making it up in the first place. Summarized alerts will be italics to differentiate them, and they may be disabled on an app-by-app basis from the lock screen. 2. Renamed camera control toggle. iPhone 16 owners will discover a tiny adjustment in the camera control area of the settings app. The toggle for AE/AF has now been modified to lock focus and exposure, which should make it substantially easier for non-photographers to comprehend exactly what the toggle does. 3. Genmoji comes to messages. Tapping the plus button in any messages chat has long been used to open up the sidebar, which has a variety of various features and choices. Genmoji, which helps you build bespoke emojis using generative AI, is now among them, offering you another chance to write your own prompts to create your own fresh new emojis. 4. PDF editing cautions. Anyone modifying a PDF through the screenshot interface will now get a warning if they try and crop content out. The warning reminds out that cropping the document won't truly erase any data, and some PDF viewers may still be able to see what you cut out. 5. Repeating options in calculator. iOS 18 actually saw a modest decrease to the official calculator app, with repeating operations removed. Essentially, this would enable you to repeat the last command you placed into the calculator when clicking the equal sign. So entering in 2x2 equals 4, then pressing the equal sign again would multiply the number by 2, giving you 8. That capability is returning in the iOS 18.3 beta, offering you one more way to calculate on your phone. Now let's move to the camera side. One of the most major things generating excitement in the tech sector is the prospective shift in camera design. Apple is said to be replacing the famous triangle camera setup with a sleek, modern horizontal or vertical bar layout. This revamp would align the iPhone 17 Pro and Pro Max with major competitors like the Google Pixel and Samsung Galaxy, which have already adopted similar configurations. Beyond mere aesthetics, this alteration could have far-reaching repercussions for the device's internal space management. By optimizing the arrangement, Apple may be able to include larger sensors or enhance heat dissipation, ultimately increasing the camera's performance. For users, this implies a more simplified, contemporary style without compromising on functionality. The iPhone 17 Pro variants are said to include unique 48-megapixel sensors across all three rear cameras, including the telephoto and ultra-wide lenses. This uniform resolution could contribute to a dramatic improvement in image quality, offering clearer, more detailed photos, especially when zooming in or recording wide-angle shots. Moreover, the digital zoom capabilities of the iPhone 17 Pro and Pro Max are projected to stretch up to an astonishing 50x, signifying a major boost over current versions. Whether you're taking faraway landscapes or focusing on fine details, these additions could raise your photography experience to new heights. Even the basic iPhone 17 is expected to benefit from camera advancements, particularly in the ultra-wide lens category. Rumors say that the ultra-wide lens may also receive a 48-megapixel sensor, essentially reducing the performance gap between the ordinary and Pro models. This upgrade could dramatically improve low-light photography and produce better results for expansive photos, allowing users greater creative flexibility and the potential to shoot breathtaking, high-quality images in a wider range of settings. While it may seem like a little tweak, the alleged modest aperture modification on the Pro model's main wide sensor might have a profound impact on light intake and image quality. The shift from f/1.3 to f/1.28 may appear modest, but it might dramatically increase the camera's performance, particularly in low light conditions. For users, this equates to brighter, more colorful photographs with greater depth and clarity, especially in tough lighting circumstances. Whether you're shooting memories at a candlelight meal or photographing a sunset, the iPhone 17 Pro and Pro Max cameras are intended to provide amazing results. The front-facing camera is also slated to receive a substantial improvement, with speculations predicting a 24-megapixel sensor, double the quality of current models. This increase could result in remarkably crisper and more detailed selfies, making the iPhone 17 Pro and Pro Max perfect for group photographs, video calls, or vlogging. Additionally, there are whispers of a broader field of view being introduced, ensuring that everyone fits properly within the frame without any distortion. Whether you're shooting memories with friends or connecting with loved ones via FaceTime, the improved front-facing camera is poised to give an unrivaled experience. Apple is slated to introduce the highly anticipated iPhone 17 lineup in September 2024, with availability following shortly after the formal announcement. While pricing is reported to remain consistent with current models, it's crucial to remember that regional differences may exist owing to variables such as currency changes and import costs. If you're going to upgrade your gadget, this timeframe provides adequate opportunity to prepare and budget accordingly. The iPhone 17 Pro and Pro Max are shaping up to be groundbreaking developments in smartphone technology, notably in the domain of photography. From the revised camera arrangement to the better sensors and enhanced zoom capabilities, these smartphones are ready to deliver an unsurpassed user experience. Whether you're a professional photographer trying to push the boundaries of mobile photography or a casual user seeking to record life's precious moments in amazing detail, the anticipated features of the iPhone 17 Pro and Pro Max cameras are guaranteed to exceed your expectations. As the release date approaches, the iPhone 17 series is likely to leave a lasting effect on the smartphone market and revolutionize what's possible with mobile photography. So that is all for today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe to our channel for more tech news and updates. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.